It was a year of first for the Indiana State University football team in 1983. Coach Dennis Raitt's crew advanced to its first postseason playoff action ever, and the team was rated in the top 10 for the first time, finishing the season at number 5. The Sycamores landed 6 players on the first team All-Missouri Valley squad, and defensive end Ed Martin was a first team All-American. It was truly a year of first, and with 16 starters returning for next year, the Sycamores will be shooting for a first place finish among the nation's 1AA teams. The 1983 football season will long be remembered by the Sycamore faithful for excitement, entertainment, and most of all, winning. Coach Dennis Raitt's team compiled an 8-3 regular season record, tying for the second best mark in the history of the school. ISU had more than its share of bright moments in 83, and the brightest to come. But few moments in Indiana State athletic history will be remembered like the September night in Gainesville, Florida, where the Sycamores came oh so close to knocking off the powerful and top 10 ranked Florida Gators. The 1983 season opener was played in Terre Haute, and the game proved to feature two tenacious defenses and two very good football teams. Indiana State and Northeast Louisiana hooked up in an outstanding battle that the Sycamores won 10-9. Both teams proved to be top 10 1AA football powers by season's end. Indiana State took the opening drive and moved into position for a 22-yard Scott Bridges field goal. But Northeast tailback Bobby Craighead advanced the pigskin 80 yards on the very first play from scrimmage for a go-ahead touchdown. But Indiana State fought back on a Darrell Clardy 1-yard run and took a 10-7 halftime lead. The visitors could manage only a safety in the second half, and they also missed 4 field goals, including a 36-yarder near the final gun, and that gave Indiana State its opening game victory. Game 2 also in Terre Haute, but it proved to be a far easier win for the Indiana State squad. The Sycamores dominated Northern Iowa 26-0, getting 24 points in the first half. Again, the defense had its day, limiting Northern Iowa to just 116 total yards. Jeff Miller was the offensive star with 2 touchdowns scored and 139 yards passing. Heavy underdogs the next week at Florida, the Sycamores fought tooth and nail against the mighty Gators. Indiana State even assumed a 13-10 lead after 3 periods, had the ball in Florida territory late in the game in an effort to overcome a 17-13 deficit. Tailback Darrell Clardy ran for 78 yards and 1 touchdown, but sustained an injury which finally forced him to the sidelines for the year. However, the near miss drew Sycamore praise from throughout the nation. The next week proved to be a relatively easy one for Indiana State as it broke from a 10-7 halftime advantage to a comfortable 33-7 victory against visiting Central Missouri State. Quarterback Jeff Miller threw 3 touchdown passes in that game, and the Indiana State defense held Central Missouri to just 7 yards rushing as the Sycamores upped their overall mark to 3-1. The next week, however, was one the ISU faithful will soon forget. Before a CBS-TV regional television audience, Illinois State handed Indiana State its worst defeat of the season, 37-20. Nothing went right early as Illinois State jumped to a 37-7 advantage early in the third quarter. One bright spot for Indiana State was the play of halfback Kevin Henderson, who was subbing for the injured Darrell Clardy. Henderson scored twice, rushed for 158 yards, but Indiana State had to return home and regroup. The next week was more to everyone's liking, except visiting rival Ball State. The Sycamores broke from a 7-7 halftime tie to record a 35-14 victory, thus making it 3 in a row over Ball State and 4 wins in the last 5 outings against the arch-rival team from Muncie. Henderson again proved to be a star with 98 yards and 3 touchdowns. Wichita State was the next ISU victim, but it was hardly easy. The Sycamores escaped with a 24-22 win after trailing 14-7 at the intermission. Miller threw for a season-high 249 yards and 1 touchdown while scoring another one on the ground. The high-powered Shockers never gave up, but Indiana State was 2 points better, raised the mark to 5-2. A wet homecoming still had all the buildup and excitement as two top 10 rated teams, Southern Illinois and Indiana State, prepared to do battle. The visiting Salukis entered the contest 7-0, rated 2 in the nation, and when they left, they were 8-0 and number 1. SIU jumped to a 31-0 advantage in the second period. Nothing went right for the home team. But the Sycamores never did quit, and with the help of an exciting fake punt, nearly had the Salukis in trouble. However, it was not to be, and Southern got a 34-21 win. The loss the previous week might have taken the starch out of lesser teams, but Indiana State responded to the challenge. Traveling to Charleston for a match against number 7 Eastern Illinois, the defense returned to form in a 17-13 Indiana State win. Joe Downing's 47-yard punt return set up the fourth quarter game winner, and the Sycamores were back on track. A journey to West Texas State was next for ISU, and the Sycamores got win number 7 with a 31-20 victory. Jeff Miller was Missouri Valley Conference Player of the Week with 2 touchdown passes, 193 yards, and he also ran for another score. Kevin Henderson had 116 yards rushing. The final regular season contest was really no contest at all. Indiana State beat Drake 38-0 in the snow of Des Moines as quarterback Miller hit 18 of 22 aerials for 218 yards, and the defense limited Drake to 167 yards. Indiana State was now 8-3. At the end of the regular season, Indiana State was the nation's fifth-rated NCAA Division I-AA team and were selected to host a first-round game in the playoffs. It was truly a memorable day in Sycamore sports as ISU rode the toe of kicker Scott Bridges to an exciting 16-13 double overtime victory against Eastern Illinois. Both teams had kicked field goals in the last 4 minutes of regulation, and the contest was knotted at 10. ISU had the ball first in the first overtime session, and Bridges converted on his second three-pointer of the day, but Eastern Illinois matched that effort. Linebacker Quentin Michael intercepted an EIU pass in the second extra period, and Bridges again converted for Indiana State's win. The 9th victory of the season matched the most wins ever for an Indiana State team. The next week, ISU traveled to Carbondale, Illinois for its second meeting against the nation's top 1AA team, Southern Illinois. After roaring to a quick 7-0 lead behind a 44-yard run by tailback Kevin Henderson and a 4-yard touchdown pass from Jeff Miller to Don Hitz, the Sycamores could not get on track and finished its season with a 23-7 loss. At year's end, the Kodak Company, in conjunction with the American Football Coaches Association, picked a 24-man 1AA All-American team. Indiana State defensive end Ed Martin, a 2-time All-Missouri Valley Conference pick, was one of the 24 best players in the nation as picked by Kodak. Additionally, several other Sycamores were honored both by the Missouri Valley Conference and the Terre Haute Exchange Club. 6 members of the 1983 Sycamore football team were chosen to the first team All-League squad, and 4 players were picked to the second team along with 1 honorable mention choice. On the first team were quarterback Jeff Miller, offensive tackle Bob Coney, center Richard Dawson, defensive end Ed Martin, linebacker Quentin Michael, and defensive back Kevin Ramsey. Second team picks included offensive guard Steve Buxton, wide receiver Anthony Kimball, defensive tackle Brad Verdon, and defensive back Wayne Davis. Running back Kevin Henderson was an honorable mention choice, as well as being runner-up in the balloting for Conference Newcomer of the Year. The Terre Haute Exchange Club chooses weekly award winners for the offensive and defensive standouts of each game, and this year handed out 27 awards. At season's end, they pick a most valuable offensive and defensive player, and this year's honors went to quarterback Jeff Miller and defensive end Ed Martin. Miller was twice named the Missouri Valley Conference Player of the Week, while defensive back Regis Mason and linebacker Quentin Michael each won the award once from the league. Miller, only a sophomore, was named to the District 4 All-Academic Team for the second straight year. Jeff set several school records this season, including most completions, 143, most yards passing, 1,762, and most yards in total offense, 2,088. Jeff is from Ossian, Indiana, and will be striking fear into opposing teams for two more seasons, and will probably end his career as the all-time leader in virtually every passing category and become another Sycamore All-American. Two other Sycamore seniors to be, Wayne Davis, a defensive back, and Steve Buxton, an offensive guard, are candidates for All-American honors next year as well. Both have the potential for professional careers after graduation. Three former ISU players currently are making their living in the professional ranks, including Tunch Ilkin with the Pittsburgh Steelers, Craig Schaefer with the St. Louis Cardinals, and Eric Robinson of the Washington Federals. Several current team members are expected to get their shot at the pro game also. The best of Sycamore football is still to come. Indiana State returns 16 starters from this year's 9-4 squad. Nine players on offense return, while seven defenders will be back, plus both kickers. With one of the toughest 1AA schedules in the country, there is plenty of room for talented newcomers to make their contribution to this winning football program. The Sycamores play four 1A schools next season, and future schedules include games with the University of Kansas and Georgia Tech, as well as trips in the late 1980s to Central Florida in Orlando. Not everyone who has made a positive impact on the Indiana State football program has been the highly recruited athlete from the high school ranks. The Sycamore football staff welcomes and encourages walk-ons to test themselves to make the grade. Case in point is that of current St. Louis Cardinal and former Missouri Valley Conference Defensive Player of the Year, Craig Schaefer, who beat the odds to start three seasons at linebacker for Indiana State. Current starters Rick DeWenger, a fullback, Troy Johnson, a linebacker, and kickers Chuck Staniford and Scott Bridges all came up through the walk-on ranks and earned financial aid. The Indiana State football program is building a tradition with good athletes and good people. Everyone associated with ISU football is proud of its reputation, which was built with hard work. A winning season, national ranking, postseason play, a great schedule, and plenty of recognition, including television exposure, has made Indiana State football synonymous with success. The 1984 season starts at home September 8th against rival Eastern Illinois. September 15th, Indiana State travels to Wichita, Kansas to meet Missouri Valley Conference member Wichita State. September 22nd, Illinois State comes to Terre Haute in another Missouri Valley Conference contest. Central Missouri plays the Sycamores at Memorial Stadium September the 29th. October 6th, Indiana State meets cross-state rival Ball State in the new Hoosier Dome in Indianapolis. The following week, the Sycamores travel to Louisville to meet the Cardinals. Homecoming this year, October 20th, and the Drake Bulldogs provide the competition. October 27th, the Sycamores travel to Carbondale, Illinois to meet the 1983 1AA champion Southern Illinois Salukis. November 3rd, ISU returns home to play Central Florida. November 10th, the last home game of the season, is against the Hurricanes of Tulsa. The regular season ends November 17th with the Sycamores traveling to Western Illinois.